Episode 5 of Loki brought us President Loki, the Thanos copter, and even a nod to the Living Tribunal, but the most interesting and potentially important intro comes from the introduction of Eliath, that mean space cloud. So let's take a look at who slash what it is and why it could point to who's pulling the strings of the TVA. Also, more spoilers if you're not caught up yet. Since Eliath is such a Marvel Comics deep cut, there isn't a huge amount that we actually know about him. From his introduction in 1993, there's only been 6 appearances of him and only one mention in a Fantastic Four anniversary comic, which was really just a large exposition dump in 2011. But his lack of appearances doesn't mean that he's just some leftover dust from a cosmic vacuum. He actually controls a large portion of a place called Limbo, which is how time travelers make their way around the timelines. Imagine Limbo is like a major train station while the tracks are the individual timelines themselves. Not to mention that the actual amount of time that he calls his in Limbo runs into the billions of years before life on Earth. Eliath also claims to be the very first being to not be bound by the shackles of time, which means he spends his days roaming different timelines, eating whatever he comes in contact with to absorb their temporal energy, which makes it seem like they might have accidentally just combined Galactus and Eliath together for that one Fantastic Four movie that we tend not to talk about. Which doesn't actually narrow it down too much, but that's enough speculation. With Eliath being a massive time black hole, everything that he comes in contact with, he absorbs, which adds to his mass. Not only that, you'd think that with a time problem, you could just go back to before he was created and stop it there, but that wouldn't work for Eliath because he puts off negative temporal energy, which acts as a sort of failsafe, so nobody can do that. Oh, and he can also teleport, so there's really nowhere to run either. Eliath's influence doesn't just stop at whatever timeline he's in either. Timelines that diverge from his current one are also affected in various ways, so he doesn't even need to physically be in a given timeline to absorb it. So Eliath is what we call in the astrophysics and metaphysics communities a very big problem. Eliath in the show, however, doesn't seem to be as scary though. I mean, he's still a giant time monster, but it's less ominous, incomprehensible cosmic terror and more wild animal who's just hungry. In the show, Eliath doesn't seem to have anything resembling what you'd probably call agency or any real sense that Eliath is doing anything outside of an animalistic need to feed. In the comics, it's a much different story. Eliath speaks with the same dubious diction that comic villains just love to use, and he is shown to have the capacity to have wants as he wants to increase his empire across time, and he's considered to be the ultimate rival to a certain time traveler with a penchant for plundering. Which brings us to why Eliath is so important. In the comics, Eliath is the sworn enemy of Kang the Conqueror. Now, Kang's history is a little murky, which happens when your whole deal is related to temporal tomfoolery, but his connections to the greater Marvel Universe is incredibly important because of his potential relationships to Reed Richards, aka Mr. Fantastic, and the GOAT himself, Dr. Victor Von Doom. Kang is usually a villain of the Avengers and the Fantastic Four, however, he's been a thorn in multiple character sides, like Black Bolt, the Timekeepers, and even a version of Thanos that had merged with like 99% of all the cosmic entities. So yeah, he's kind of a big deal, but the TLDR version is Kang is a super smart time traveler from the 31st century, or 41st century, it's kind of all over the place, who's had more aliases than one person really needs, who likes adding various timelines to his empire, hence the whole Conqueror part of his name. With all that in mind, the ramifications of not only including Kang and Loki, but featuring him as the mastermind behind the TVA are wide-reaching, especially with Marvel exploring more of the multiverse with the new Doctor Strange movie, as well as with many of the rumors surrounding Spider-Man No Way Home. This version of Kang has even seemingly tamed his longtime foe into becoming a sort of guard dog to ensure that no one can reach him, which could make him one of the most powerful incarnations of the character. Kang is just an MCU theorist's best friend because even if it's not directly related to Kang in the comics, the MCU can use the all-powerful hand wave to just say, Kang did it when messing with time, and it works. Want mutants to start popping up? Oh, that was just Kang messing around. Want the Fantastic Four to finally show up? Just say Kang went back in time to make sure that his potential ancestor survived some event. With Loki and Sylvie being in the void, not to be mistaken with another cosmic nightmare creature, this could be the MCU version of Limbo as it serves as a sort of centralized point where timelines essentially go to be disposed of. Kang even has a trophy room at the end of space-time, and since that's where Loki is right now, maybe we could see even more cool Easter eggs a la Odin's vault from Thor Ragnarok. Kang, similar to some extent to Loki, is just a mischief maker, but instead of magic, Kang uses time. With the central plot of Loki revolving around time, keeping it on a predetermined path, and the idea of variance, which Kang has a lot of experience with, it makes total sense that Kang would be behind the TVA. Or this is another Mephisto situation, and none of this is right. Kang is already set to appear in the Ant-Man and the Wasp sequel, Quantumania, but who's to say that we can't get a sneak peek in the final episode of Loki's first season? Eliath is cool and all, but his introduction makes way for even cooler characters and concepts. It's only a matter of time that we see how those concepts turn out. Get it? A matter of time? Just needed to get one more time pun in there.